The baobab gave me amazing pictures, which were completely unexpected. I really have a deep inner connection when I work with a tree. It's calling me to work with it.
And then Connie came to me and she said, in the very particular period of my life when I actually read a couple of books about trees, how they communicate, how they grow, what their roots do together if they cannot have seeds, what is their mentality, what is the way of their communication.
This area is wonderful, it's very, very old, and of course a baobab tree is something which is very specific for Africa. So baobab has, I'm sure, not only for a European visitor, but also in particular, of course, for the local population, a very specific cause, a very specific reason, and a very specific use, and a magic. And you don't even have to be as far as Birgitta is going, or is able to go. The sheer sight of a baobab already gives a very specific feeling. And I always ask, where is the next baobab? Because there are not very many up in the region, but wherever you can find one, it's very good to go. Just go, take a look, and I would say, when I stand there, like always in front of old buildings or old stones, I always try to say, if these stones could talk, what would they tell me over the several hundred years a baobab, thousand years a baobab can become old? And now we've found somebody who shows us that trees talk.
I don't know, I still don't know how you could find out these amazing pieces. If the trees speak to you, you speak to the trees as well. Because when I will face a baobab, I'm not so sure that I will see the same. So it's a question of mixture of cultures. Normally, as an ambassador, we are mixing our cultures, and especially here in FNCC, between France media or all our colleagues posting here in the media, you are opening a completely new area. We are mixing our culture with nature here in the media, and this is, at the same time, very simple and very modern approach. So thank you very much.
Got some local people were able to show me the baobab, the Livingston baobab, which was not sure to be the Livingston baobab, but there were people claiming to be, they know where the tree was. So in 2010, I was up there for holidays, and I decided one day I'm going to spend just finding this tree. So after sitting for about 2 or 3 hours with the local Indunas under the tree and having long conversations, and there was a bit of a secrecy about the tree, and you felt a bit uncomfortable. It was kind of, they didn't want to show us the tree and so on. But eventually we got to the tree, and yeah, it was just amazing. It was to see this tree, it was midday, and so your light is from the top, but still it was like this massive structure standing there. And as Christian was saying, you wonder if this tree could speak, you know, what could it tell you? So when we left the tree, I had a funny feeling there's more going to happen here. There's more to this tree than just the tree where Livingston left his wagon before going further on his trail to Gouda to find the Zambezi.